Hey guys, Lillian here from Lily Ray's Collection. I am back, and this is per request. Someone requested that I show or demonstrate how I do my homemade glimmer mist. This is the actual bottle for glimmer mist. And see on the bottom there? That is this eyeshadow. And these are all eyeshadows from the dollar store. So I take and I just add this alcohol into the bottle. And then I open, this opens on the bottom. Of course it opens on the top. Okay, it has a brush. When I'm doing small pieces, I just use the brush. But if I'm going to put some in a bottle, I will either turn the bottle upside down and tap, 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 and it goes right in, or you can just pop this open. Okay? So I'm going to just demonstrate one because it's on E, and it's one of the colors that I'm going to use for the doilies. So this is my box so that I don't make a mess on my desk. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and put the alcohol in. And I use alcohol because it dries faster. You could use water. Some people with medical issues should use the water, not the alcohol. I put about, 20 dots of this. This is the Tim Holtz alcohol ink. Okay, so that was 20. Let me just show you what that is. I hope you could see that. And then I also add, to tone the green down, this one, which is, I believe it's teak. I should get my glasses. Oh, this one is honeycomb. All right, and I do the same. About 10 dots, check it, and then if I want it a little more browner, greenish brown, because I like I like it. I have seaweed in my head, but it's not seaweed. But I like a dark green. I'm gonna shake this. This has the glimmer mist in it, but I'm gonna put more so I could show you. And I shake it side to side because when I shake it up and down, it clogs the little tube inside. So let me go ahead. I'm gonna put the glimmer in there. Now, because that's green, I'm going to use this one. This one's actually, this one's like an orange, a pearl. Let me see. I can't see the color. It's so... I can't see the color, but it is... We'll see how this turns out. It's like a pearly pastel orange. So I just tap it, and I, you know, I could see how it's falling. I don't want too much in there because too much will clog it. See how it's in there? I hope you could see that. And if you see that it stops coming out, just turn it over and just see what happens now. Oh, mossy. That's the color I want. Moss. Moss green. Look at that shimmer. Uh-huh. Beautiful. And then we're going to test it out on our doilies. And I also have cheesecloth. I may put some brown in this. Let's see what happens here. Let's see what color we have. I'm gonna hold it like that. Oh wow, that is pretty. Yep, pretty pretty. I'm gonna do the cheesecloth as well. It's gonna be different colors. I'm going to use the green, the red or pink, and then brown. Make sure that you are, I have two, my desk fan going and my ceiling fan going, because this does has alcohol. I also have this one that's like a, it's called, oh my god, I can't remember. See how it clogs? Come on, baby. Oh, I gotta fix that. I need that brown. I need that color. Okay, this is the other one. See how it's on the bottom there? And see the bits in there? It gets into the tube and then it clogs it up. So just do it side to side. And once a month I take these out, I soak them in the water, let them unclog, and then I put them all back. Look at that, how beautiful. This one. I've cut it a couple of times. Alright, let's see. I'm going to use the nozzle for the green one. Let's see if that comes out. See, this one's mossier. Let me put that upside down here. Fingers getting tired. Okay. So we're going to dry this. Take this out of the way so I don't spill this. Okay. one of the lights. I need to get a strip so that I have enough outlets. You could see the shimmer on this, but I certainly can. You see that shimmer? Dry yet, but it can dry on its own. We're going to be working with these doilies. So the next step for these doilies is I didn't get anything out. Oh my gosh. Let me grab my stuff and I'll be right back. Alright, I think we have everything that we need. I want to use this, it's a splat. A splat clear stamp. I want to do splat all over this with, I don't know whether to do. I haven't decided what I want to do. Let's do the splat with the pink. So I'm just going to randomly do splats. Just random. So those are the splatters. And then I have this. I may want to just stamp it on, because these are going to be folded on a page. So I could stamp a word going this way and one this way. So let's see what I have here. Going to do, it's hard working with the gloves. We're going to do laughter on one of them. Did I put that right? No, of course I didn't. There, laughter. And I want to do it in VersaMark ink. Don't look at my pad. It's all cruddy and shiny, but it has enough. What I put in here is I put glycine. Actually, let me show you. this pad, you can take it and wash it, clean it. And then what I use is this vegetable glycerin. And you could use this on your skin, you could use this in your hair, you could use this. This is natural. And it's, as it says, softens and moisturizes, multi-purposes. Okay? And you just drop a couple of drops and you put the cap on it, and it saturates your pad. And you never have to buy this again. Because Versamark, these things are very expensive. So I just wash it. As you could see, I've been working with it. I wash it and add some glycerin. Glycerin is good for the hair, the nails, everything. I use it for everything. And look how saturated that pad is. I'll show you. I don't know if you could see it, but you see that? Actually, I should be doing it like this. Let's try this side first. Let me cover this. I'm going to try one, and I'm going to use some This is ultra thick embossing powder. I put it in this can. So I'm going to lift the doily. I don't know if I had enough glycerin on that, but we'll see. Heat gun. Since we've already used it, the gun is hot. I'm going to go ahead and can you see that? How sparkly it is? Now it's changing. There it is. I don't know if you could see that, but I can certainly see that. And you can read it as well. Just be careful you don't burn your fingers. Okay. Alright. There you have it. Laughter. So this one is going to go like this. Like that. And then on the other side, we'll have another word. So I'm going to put laughter on all of these while I have this out. I'm going to actually, let's do smile. And I clean that with a wipey. I think I gotta sink the Versamark, or rather the dye, the clear stamp into the Versamark to saturate it. I can't see, but I'm going to stamp. Okay. Do the same thing. Oh, this is not the right doily, but I guess it doesn't matter. Because we have to do all of them. See how much easier it is to have it in a container? No mess. But always cover that so that you don't have a mess or an accident. Okay, I'm bringing this one up to see if you can see the point changes. See it changing? Oh yes, I see it now. I think that's good enough. Maybe I'll just do one side of each doily. Move on to the next. I'm going to have to clean these all with a wiping. I will do that once we're done. Let's do, because it's a vintage journal, let's do the word love. Stay put. Let me put it down before it falls out. I rock it. There it is. Careful that you don't burn your fingers. It's gonna change. There it goes. Very subtle. All right, one more. Oh man, it's because of the glycerin, they're falling off. Oh my goodness. Let's do this one. It says, "I love us." This is the glycerin that you see. It's messy but effective. Okay, so let me make sure I see. I love us. Thank you. we're done with this. Okay, so let me clean up and I will be right back, okay? Let me just get this so I don't ruin my lens. Okay, I'm back. Cleaned up, ready for the next step. Now, this is what I use, Art Minds Decoupage Glue Sealer Gloss Finish. And I put this on top of the doilies so that the doilies don't break. So what I do first is I want to ink the edges. And because this Distress Oxide Walnut Stain, these are all ink reactive, so they react with water, with any kind of gel or liquid. And I just lightly darken the edges. This, when you darken the edges like this, this brings out, as you can see, the difference in the pink and the green. Doesn't have to be too dark. Look at the difference in that. I know this is a lot of work, but when I make a book, I always think about what I would buy and the details in what I'm looking at. And so for me, the details are very important. I think that's what makes the book are all of the small details. Because, you know, pages are pages. But what details are within those pages to make your eyes say, that looks yummy, it looks so pretty. That's what I like. All right, so now that that's done, we're going to go ahead, if I could get this open. What I do is I just add some to the brush. On both sides. And then I just slightly bathe it in the decoupage. There is a little fly in here, Nat. It has been just sprayed, but I can see that darn gnat. If you need a little more, just pour a little more. But I do it this way so I don't contaminate what's inside the bottle. This one. Whoop. And these doilies, I get them from, not Michael's, because they're pretty cheap at Michael's. I get them at Paper Source. Paper Mart. You get 1,000 in a box. Okay, let me put my cover on this. Okay. Make sure that's sealed well so that it doesn't dry. And I take a wipey and put my brush in it until I get ready to put it into water. I wash it out and I reuse it. Okay, let's dry this a little bit. I think that should be dry. So, yeah. I didn't do the back because it's going to be folded. And then the last step is I go in and I do my edges again. But trying just to get the edges. I think that's gorgeous. I mean, one day you could just sit down and do doilies in different colors and stamp them and get them ready. You know, I look at my paper and I see what I have and then work accordingly. And if you do them neutral like this, they'll go with anything that you put together because it's vintage. I love working with vintage items or making them. Okay. Let's take them out of this. And I do the same thing with this here. I tap, 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 tap. Couple of times since I didn't have my brown spray, I do the same thing with this. Just tap it so that it has some brown in it, and then you could use this within that journal any place that you want as a background, put into the tabs, just anywhere. You know, make your flowers, use it with the flowers. And that's getting the edges. Cheesecloth. Yep. That's it. Okay. So now you see we have a set. I love these colors. Let's take this out so that we can see it in a better... Actually, I'm going to put this over here. Laughter, love. This one says, I love you, smile. And then you have your cheesecloth. All right, guys. Well, I hope that you enjoyed this. Now, that's going to go into the journal, but that's going to be in another session. For tonight, we are done. Please hit the like if you like. Subscribe and share. And I will see you next time. Take care. I did my nails.